गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम शिवराज सिंह। इन दिस क्लास आई विल टीच यू इंग्लिश चैप्टर फर्स्ट क्लास 10। द टाइटल ऑफ दिस चैप्टर इज गुडविल। इन दिस चैप्टर द पोएम फ्रॉम यजुर्वेद इज गिवन। दिस इज एक्चुअली अ हिम, इट इज अ वर्स। Let us start the introduction of this poem. This poem has been taken from Yajurveda. This hymn is an extract from Yajurveda chapter 34, which is one of the four Vedas. Other than Yajurveda, there are three more Vedas: Rig Veda, Sam Veda, and Athar Veda. These are considered to be an ancient books. The date of the Veda is contradictory. It means it is not sure when the Vedas were written. Bal Gangadhar Tilak assigned the date of Veda 4500 BC. BC means before the birth of Jesus Christ. Before his birth, 4500 years ago, Vedas were written according to Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and Max Müller assigned it between 2500 to 1500 BC. Vedas are the most ancient books. These are the most ancient literary works of the world. Before Vedas, no literature was written. They deal with the deity, creation, and existence. Here, deity means God. Creation means the world which was created by the God. And existence means the presence of God and human and all other living beings. In this hymn, the divine essence means this is the part of God. The peerless spirit means the spirit which is peerless. Peerless means unique, which cannot be compared to any other thing. The deathless flame. Deathless means which never dies. The poet has invoked to that divine essence, the peerless spirit and the deathless flame. And for what has he called? He says that, O God, you put the will, the desire in my mind so that I perform only good deed. Here in this line you can see the deathless flame are invoked to put the will in the mind to do only what is good. It means the poet has invoked, he has called the divine essence, the peerless spirit, to put the desire in his mind, Jivatma, to perform the good deeds. There is a divine nature in the spirit of man, which is also a part of the divine essence, spirit of God. Here, poet says, it is said that the spirit which is present in the God, that spirit is also present in human body or in all living creatures. The wise men that are perfect in observing rituals are controlled by their divine nature. It means the human being who are good in nature, if they can control their desire, that is because of the divine nature, divine essence, which is present in them. As the fleet-footed horses are controlled by reins, so our fleshly desires are controlled by the mind in us. It means, as the fleet-footed horse, uncontrollable horse, are controlled by the charioteer with the help of rein. Rein means a string, a thin string with which the charioteer controls the horse. In the same way, the divine essence, which is the essence of God, that should come and it should put the desire in our mind so that our mind should perform only good deeds. So this was the introduction in which it is said that poet has invoked the supernatural power, the divine essence of God, to put the will, to put the desire in the human mind, in the jivatma, to perform the good deeds. Let us start the text. First stanza. May that by which wise men is skillful in rituals. May that by which wise men, it means because of which wise men, the men who are wise, who are intelligent, they are skillful in rituals. Rituals means the task, the observation or the ceremony which is performed by people. So because of which the wise men are perfect, they are skillful in their ceremonies and steady in assemblies. Assemblies means the gatherings in which people assemble and they perform their tasks. So people gather together and they are steady, means continuously performing their task in assemblies, that peerless spirit, and they are performing because of which I call to that peerless spirit. Peerless means, just I told you, that a unique spirit which cannot be compared with any other thing. So poet calls that supernatural power to put the will in our mind so that we can perform only good tasks. Here in third line, the peerless spirit that lies in all creatures. It means this peerless spirit, this unique spirit, is present in all living being. Actually, it is present in all living being. So naturally it is present in the body of poet also. Even then he is calling the supernatural power. So for what is he calling? He is calling because, according to poet, he cannot control his desires himself. He is unable to control his mind. That's why he has invoked to the supernatural power, which can control his mind and he can guide the man to perform the good deeds. May that which is deep knowledge, intellect, memory, that which is the deathless flame in living being, because of which we have the deep knowledge, we have intelligence, we have intellect, we have memory, and I call to that deathless flame. Deathless flame means the flame, the spirit which is deathless, who never dies, and that is present in all living being. I call to that spirit, that supernatural power, to guide us so that I perform only good deeds, without which nothing whatever is done. We cannot perform any task without spirit, without the divine essence, without the soul. So I call to that supernatural power which should guide us to perform good deeds. May that by which May that which guides men like a good charioteer, who controls fleet-footed horses with the reins. Here, poet has compared the charioteer and thus divine essence. He says that just as a good charioteer controls fleet-footed horse. Fleet-footed horse means uncontrolled horse, who, if they are not controlled, they can run from here to there. In any direction they can run away, but even the fleet-footed horses can be controlled with the reins. In the same way, that supernatural power should also control our mind, because as the horses are fleet-footed, they are not in control. If they are not controlled by the reins, in the same way, our mind is also very swift. It is most swift and active. Swift means very fast. It runs here and there. It does not stay at one place. So poet says that the supernatural power, which is the divine essence, that should come and it should control our mind. Here mind means jivatma. It should control our mind because it is very swift and active, and it can be controlled only by the divine essence. So it should come and it guide us so that we can perform only good deeds. So students, I have explained you the meaning of this text in English. Now you listen the explanation in Hindi. May that by which wise men skillful in rituals, जिसकी वजह से, जिस सुपर नेचुरल पावर की वजह से वाइज मैन रिचुअल्स परफॉर्म करने में स्किलफुल होते हैं, दे आर परफेक्ट इन परफॉर्मिंग द रिचुअल्स एंड स्टडी इन असेंबलीज, दे परफॉर्म देयर टास्क, वो अपने काम असेंबलीज में यानी ग्रुप में कंटिन्यूसली परफॉर्म करते रहते हैं. दैट पियरलेस स्पिरिट, और उस स्पिरिट को जिसकी वजह से इतना सब कुछ करने में हम एबल हो पाते हैं, हम उस पीयरलेस स्पिरिट को, उस यूनिक स्पिरिट को कॉल करते हैं जो सभी क्रिएचर में अवेलेबल होती है, प्रेजेंट होती है, और हम उस सुपरनेचुरल पावर को कॉल करते हैं ताकि वो आए और हमारे माइंड को इस तरह से रिजॉल्व करे, सेट करे, गाइड करे, ताकि हम सिर्फ गुड डीड्स ही परफॉर्म करें, अच्छे काम ही करें. स्टेंजा सेकंड, मे दैट विच इज डीप नॉलेज इंटेलेक्ट मेमोरी, जिसकी वजह से हमारे अंदर डीप नॉलेज है, हमारे अंदर इंटेलेक्ट है, मेमोरी है. दैट विच इज डेथलेस फ्लेम इन लिविंग बींग, और वो डेथलेस फ्लेम जो सभी लिविंग बींग में प्रेजेंट है. Without which nothing whatever is done, जिसके बिना हम कोई भी काम नहीं कर सकते. हम उस supernatural power को invoke करते हैं ताकि वो आए और हमारे mind को इस तरह से guide करे कि हम अच्छे काम ही करें. यहाँ हर जगह mind का means है जीवात्मा, the spirit of living being. May that which guides men like a good charioteer, यहाँ पर पोएट ने उस सुपरनेचुरल पावर को एक गुड चैरियोटियर की तरह बताया है कि जिस तरह से एक अच्छा चैरियोटियर फ्लीट फुटेड हॉर्स को कंट्रोल करता है रेंस के थ्रू. रेंस मीन्स लगाम, वो स्ट्रिंग, वो धागा जिससे वो कंट्रोल करता है हॉर्स को, उसी तरह से वो सुपरनेचुरल पावर आए और हमारे माइंड को गाइड करे, हमारे जीवात्मा को इस तरह से सेट करे ताकि हम सिर्फ अच्छे काम ही करें. क्यों? क्योंकि हमारी जीवात्मा भी, इट इज़ मोस्ट स्विफ्ट एंड एक्टिव, इट इज़ नॉट ईजिली कंट्रोल्ड. सो उस सुपर नेचुरल पावर को कॉल किया गया है ताकि वो आए और हमारे माइंड को इस तरह से सेट करे कि हम सिर्फ अच्छे काम ही करें। सो आई होप यू हैव अंडरस्टूड दिस चैप्टर। क्वेश्चन आंसर ऑफ दिस चैप्टर यू कैन गेट इन PDF फॉर्म। वी विल प्रोवाइड इट यू लेटर। इफ़ यू हैव एनी क्वेरी यू कैन पुट कमेंट एंड आस्क योर डाउट्स। थैंक यू।